Hello, smart students. Welcome to this week's short. This is a good one because I want to tackle a question I get all the time, every single day. Well, okay, maybe not every day, but I get it a few times a month, so I know it's important. And that question is, how in the world am I supposed to include citations and a reference list in a PowerPoint? First things first, the reason this question comes up so often is because, well, there are no official guidelines for an APA PowerPoint. So the way I like to describe APA PowerPoints is that it's APA formatting with some flex room for creativity. Now, with that in mind, what's important is that if your professor gives you any specific guidelines, that you follow those guidelines first and foremost. I'm just here to give you some guidance, since I know guidance is a little hard to come by these days. So consider that as almost a disclaimer for this entire video, because I'm gonna show you the best practices, but again, if your professor says anything that deviates from what I say, make sure to follow their instructions first. Now, let's go ahead and talk about the actual citations on a PowerPoint slide. So, you know when you're writing an academic paper and you need to include in-text citations in your writing so the reader knows that the paraphrase material or the directly quoted material came from another author? It's the same thing in a PowerPoint slide, except with a PowerPoint slide, there are two places you're going to include that in-text citation. One, on the PowerPoint slide itself, and two, in the presenter notes. Now, when it comes to the reference list, it's actually very similar to how you would include it in an academic paper, in that it's going to be at the end of the paper as the last page, and it's going to follow a double-spaced hanging indent formatting. However, let's go ahead and jump into my computer, and I'm going to walk you through examples of all of these so you're crystal clear. Okay, let's go. Well, that didn't work. Okay, let's go. One more time. Alrighty, let's go. All right, hello, welcome to our PowerPoint. So there are no in-text citations on the slides yet because I want to cover the presenter notes first. So let's go ahead and expand this so we can see what we're working with. And basically, what you need to remember about in-text citations in your presenter notes is that you're going to include them the exact same way you would your academic writing papers. So as you can see, we have one, two, and I believe there's a third one, three, here we go. Three different in-text citations included in our presenter notes. What this means is that this material that we have on our PowerPoint slide right here is paraphrased from three different sources. So now let's go over the two different ways you can include the in-text citations on your actual PowerPoint. And boom. So here's method number one. If you'll notice, I've included the in-text citation that's associated with each bullet point directly after the bullet point. So as you can see, these first three bullet points are cited, or paraphrased, pardon me, from this first source, while this fourth one is from the second source, and these last two are from the third source. Something I'd like to point out is, please note how there's no punctuation after any of these citations. This is because I'm not using a full sentence on the PowerPoint slide, therefore I'm not going to include a period after the second parenthesis. Now, let me show you the second way you can include these in-text citations on this same slide. And that is like this. So if you'll notice, instead of including an in-text citation after each bullet point, I've used the principles of citing more than one study at a time, and I've included all three on this last bullet point, signifying that the material on this page comes from these three sources. Now, this is up to you which one you use, but do keep in mind some professors prefer one over the other. Now, you might be wondering, what if all these bullet points were from the same source? Which one of these methods is most appropriate? Well, let me show you. Okay, so here we are with a slide, and these four points all come from the same source. So you can use method one and add the in-text citation after each bullet point, but honestly, that looks a little redundant. So what you can also do is only include one in-text citation after the last bullet point, like you see it is here. Personally, for this situation, I think method number two is better, but I want to show you all the different scenarios because it really is up to you to pick and choose. Now, what do you do if you have a direct quote on your PowerPoint slide? Hang on. And here we are.
So if you'll notice, this slide has both a direct quote and three bullet points. For this situation, I've chosen to include the one in-text citation after the third bullet point since they all come from the same source. Now, for the direct quote, if you'll notice, this looks exactly like how you would include the direct quote in a paper, minus there's no text before or after it. You don't necessarily need that on a PowerPoint since you want your PowerPoint slides to have concise material. I do want to point out that there is a period after the second parenthesis. The reason being is because this quotation is a full sentence. Therefore, it's appropriate to put the punctuation after the citation. Okay, so now let's talk about formatting the reference slide. What you want to do is go to the last slide in your PowerPoint. From here, you want to come up here to the Home tab and insert a new blank slide. By default, this slide is going to have a header text box and a body text box. I recommend deleting the header text box and expanding the body text box, just like this, so that way you have one big blank text box to work with. Now, the first thing you're going to do is center your text. We're going to remove that bullet point and type out the word references in bold font, just like you would as if this were a traditional reference slide. From here, go ahead and hit enter one time. Align your text flush left. You want to make sure to remove the bold. And then what I suggest doing next is going to your reference list for this PowerPoint, and let's go ahead and copy and paste these into that slide. So I'm going to come over here and hit paste. If you'll notice, it went ahead and added back in those bullet points. So now what we're going to do is reformat this to remove the bullet points, set the line spacing and the hanging indent. So as you can see, I highlighted only the reference list entries. What I'm going to do is click this button up here to remove the bullet points. Great. Now let's set the hanging indent. My favorite way to do this is you see this icon on the ruler? Well, you want to grab this second caret because this is the second line indent, and you're simply going to bring it in 1/2 inch. If you'll notice, we have the hanging indent and that looks great, but I do have a rogue bullet point here. So I'm actually going to delete that, delete any additional spaces, and then let's go ahead and re-highlight. So when it comes to your line spacing of the reference slide, you have some flexibility. It doesn't have to be double spaced at a certain font size and type. It just needs to look nice. So I'd actually argue that this almost looks nice as it is, but let's just see what a 1.5 line indent looks like, or not a line indent, line spacing looks like. Well, as you can see, that significantly minimized our text. So I might go ahead and leave it at single spaced just like that. Now, the last thing I want to touch on is the scenario of what if you have a lot more reference list entries than this? In other words, let's say you have twice as many. Obviously, they're all not going to look great fitted on one reference slide. So basically, I just want to point out that it's okay if your reference list entries span more than one reference slide. What I recommend doing if that's the case is actually double clicking on this reference slide and go ahead and duplicate the slide. So as you can see, I now have a duplicate where I can erase these reference list entries. I can go back to my document, copy the new ones, and paste them in here like this. Now, I would like to point out that it does not keep the formatting for the hanging indent, so you'll have to reset that, but it's nice to at least have references centered and bolded in the middle, and you don't have to go through the process of deleting and expanding these text boxes.
All right, smart students, that's it for today's video. By the way, if you need help actually creating the PowerPoint, meaning you want the full tutorial, be sure to check out this video up here. It's a very in-depth video on how to create an APA formatted PowerPoint slide. But for the rest of you, if you're good on this knowledge, then you're good to get going. Thank you so much for watching this video. As always, be sure to give it a big thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course, subscribe for more videos like this every week. I appreciate it. Thanks, guys.